Assalamu alaikum. My brothers and sisters, istikhara is to seek the guidance of Allah in a matter. There is a way of doing it. You actually have to read a certain supplication that is taught in the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and the companions used to learn it as though they were learning a verse of the Quran. In that dua, we are saying, oh Allah, you are the knower of the unseen, you know, we don't know, you know the future, we don't know, and we are seeking from your guidance. If this matter is good for me, then make it easy for me and grant me blessings in it and so on. And if this matter is bad for me, then, turn me away from it, turn it away from me, and then make me happy with your decree. That's basically what you're saying. You call out to Allah in a specific way. For the details, you might want to check how to do that, the dua and the istikhara. However, there is no mention ever of dreams as a response to an istikhara in revelation. So some people have suggested perhaps you get a dream, perhaps you might this. That's not from revelation, okay? From revelation, read the meaning of that dua and you will know exactly what you've asked Allah. You told Him, oh Allah, if this is good for me, make it easy for me. If this is bad for me, block it from me. So, when you've done the dua, what's the response of your istikhara? The response is on the ground. Either things become easier, or certain signs show you that everything is being facilitated, or things are being blocked and stopped and there is an obstacle and another one and a third one and so on. So if it is made easier, you told Allah that if it's good for me, make it easy for me. He's making it easier for you. And if it is not good for you, you told Him, if it's not good for me, keep it away from me. He has kept it away from you. Why? Because you told Him, if it's not good for me, my deen, my dunya, then keep it away from me. That's why, my brothers and sisters, when Allah has blocked something after you desperately wanted it and you've made an istikhara, that is the response of your istikhara. All right. Istikhara is not actually revelation from the heaven, and people may make mistakes in interpreting exactly what it is. So if you really feel desperately for something, you can try a few more times. But if you're finding that it's really difficult, I normally suggest set yourself a little deadline, and after that you can walk off and you can continue with your life rather than stop your life forever simply because something you wanted didn't come your way. You may want to try after some time, but don't stop your life for it. If Allah's blocked it, He's blocked it. Now, my brothers and sisters, remember, istikhara is something that we should be doing. We should be asking Allah, oh Allah, grant us if this is good for us. People ask a question. How come I made istikhara, I got positive results, I got married, now I'm struggling with my marriage and we're divorcing. Okay, why am I divorcing when my istikhara was positive when I was getting married? My brother, my sister, did you ever say in your dua of istikhara, oh Allah, if this marriage is never going to break, then let it happen? You didn't say that. Okay, you said, oh Allah, do for me what's better for my deen, my dunya, my akhirah, which means my religion, my livelihood, my worldly life, and my hereafter. If it's good for me in those things, facilitate it for me. If it's not, block it. That's what you said. So perhaps divorce was the best thing for you for many reasons. Number one, maybe you were supposed to become a better person, and maybe you were supposed to become closer to Allah. So it was better for your dunya, it was better for your deen. And perhaps you will later marry a much better person than the one whom you were divorced from. Subhanallah. So you don't know, it was better for you. Allah has never guaranteed that your business will flourish and if the istikhara was positive. Nor has He guaranteed that your marriage will work if the istikhara was positive. He's only telling you, what you asked for, is it's better for me, my religion, my life, and my hereafter. That's the response of istikhara. And that's why sometimes we do an istikhara, and on top of that, we still suffer a loss, because Allah knows that was better for us. So let's not be confused on this one. People always try to lose, focus, and they don't know what they've even said. That's why when you're calling out to Allah with a supplication, try and at least figure out what you're asking Allah. And then you will understand the way forward. أقول قولي هذا والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.